All right, stay on top of it. For the next 2 minutes, you are mine.
What do you mean 2 minutes? What's 2 minutes? What?
That's it, till the market closes. I don't want you to set foot off the floor. I need immediate quotes.
I need a miracle.
Hang on. We're doing all we can.
Well, I'll tell you, it's not enough. Not only that I haven't doubled my investment, I've got less than I started with.
Yeah, that can change in just a second.
Of course it can. I can lose even more.
What's that? You're not telling me what I need to hear.
What? What's that? What's he saying? What?
Sit tight. It's still dropping.
Oh, dear God.
We're taking this one right down to the wire.
Do they take people with heart conditions in prison?
It is?
What?
How much?
What? Is it up or down? What?
Up slightly.
How, what's the total? Tell me.
Just over 12 million.
That's wonderful. Sell it. Go ahead, sell it.
You want to be rich?
I want to be free. Sell the 12 million shares. Do it. Right now. Go ahead. What are you doing? I'm telling you to sell the shares.
I recommend you hang on to them a little longer.
Have you gone crazy, Stansbury? I have what I need to pay him back. Sell the shares.
You're the boss.
Right.
Okay, let's... Hello? Hello?
What? What's going on? What happened?
My contact. He's off the line.
Well, call him back.
How do you suggest I do that? He didn't hang up. He just isn't there anymore.
That's wonderful. That's great. They've got me strapped in the electric chair. They're going to throw the switch and the governor takes a coffee break.
Can't do anything till he comes back.
Why did you sell what I told you to sell? I had what I needed. Now I'm going to lose everything.
We still have a few seconds left.
I want to
left.
Tell you something. You blow my fortune, I'm going to sue you. And if I don't sue you, my father will sue you. And when he sues, nobody sues like
Hello?
My father sues.
Hello?
What, you got him back?
Yeah, where's
Sell the shares!
Guess it's now or never.
Look, there's 10 seconds left. Please, just do what I ask you. Punch the right buttons, will you?
Mm-hmm.
There's
it can still
six
change.
Seconds, 5 seconds.
Right?
4 seconds. There's 3 seconds left. There's two. There's what?
Boom.
I'm ruined.
Thanks so much. It's been a pleasure doing business as always, and I'll be in touch. Bye. Got a handkerchief? I'd hate to see you when you'd lost money.
What? What are you saying?
Congratulations. You just made $24 million.
I what? I made $24 million. You just made $24 million? You made $24 million? Oh, that's wonderful. I got sort of carried away. I'm sorry.
I'm not.
You're not?
Hmm. We have every reason to be excited. How about a proper celebration?
Don't you mean just us?
Mm-hmm. I think the least you can do is buy me a glass of champagne.
Absolutely.
Could you set me down now?
Oh, yeah. Sorry. Here you go. Well, I'm going to call Duke's place. I'm going to order the best bottle of champagne in the place because that's what you deserve, the woman who saved my life.
Say, that patient's lucky to be alive.
Well, thanks to you, he's doing fine.
Oh, Merle, I don't think it was such a bad afternoon's work, actually. Which leaves our evening free. You have any plans?
I just received an invitation to dinner and dancing tonight at Duke's.
May I ask from whom?
Scotty Baldwin.
Huh. Are you going?
I don't think so. It was very sweet of him to ask, but I'm not really up to a night on the town.
Well, I could certainly use one.
Haven't you and Alan been getting out much lately?
Alan and I haven't doing much anything lately.
Busy?
Well, yeah, you could say that.
Well, maybe he has things on his mind.
Of course he has lots of things on his mind. Problem is, there used to be a time when Alan would not even pick out a tie without consulting me first. Now, I have no idea what he is thinking, what he's doing, and...
I know the feeling.
No, you don't. No, you don't, Bobby. Jake was never as evasive as Alan is.
At least Alan didn't walk out on you.
Well, that might be the next step.
You don't mean that.
Oh, anything's possible, really.
Serious?
Yeah, I'd say it was pretty serious. I don't know why he hasn't even left me right now. I don't know that he hasn't anyway. Well, for instance, all of a sudden, he happens to be mysteriously unavailable today.
He's not here?
No. Oh, I know for sure he's not here.
Well, did you talk to Edward?
Oh, if I talked to his father, he's only going to protect his son.
Huh. Well, if I were you, I'd turn the tables on Ellen.
What do you mean?
Well, go out and have some fun. Come on, girl. If your husband is not going to accommodate you, find somebody who will.
Well, that's a lot easier said than done.
Maybe we can help each other out.
How?
Well, I'll accept Scotty's invitation tonight if you'll join us.
Oh, come on. You don't want me along.
Well, look at it this way. If you don't go, I won't go either.
Well, look, I don't really want to be a chaperone.
Well, then, think of yourself as more like a witness.
Your date's going to love that.
First of all, Scotty's not going to mind. And second of all, he's not my date. He's an old friend.
Yeah, I would have said maybe an old enemy.
Well, then come along to protect me. Please.
Okay, I will go to Duke's tonight.
Great.
This is going to be one interesting evening. I don't know how you get me into this.
Thank you very much. I've got another bottle of this chilling behind the bar. Dr. Quatermain, should the need arise.
Thank you.
All right.
Well, you're quite a woman, you know that. You're brilliant, you're incredibly attractive, charming.
More.
May I?
Please.
To our future together, professionally and personally.
May we strike gold in both arenas.
So what did I do to deserve you?
Oh, you gave a girl a chance. The rest will take care of itself.
I trust there'll be more.
It's up to you.
Then there will be more. They're going to be seeing a lot more of each other.
Well, I'll drink to that.
Allow me, please.
Hello.
Evening, Dr. Quatermain. Table for one?
No, actually, I'm meeting Scott Baldwin and Bobby. Are they here yet?
No, they're not. But his table is waiting.
Oh, good.
If you follow me.
Well, Dr. Quatermain, how nice to see you again.
Polica.
Oh, he remembered my name. Don't get up.
I'm so glad to see you.
I'll bet you are.
Yes, you'll never guess what happened.
Oh, I have a pretty good idea.
This is Cheryl Stansbury. She's my personal advisor. My financial advisor. She's my personal stockbroker.
I'm his personal wife.
How do you do?
Well, not as well as you, obviously.
Well, thanks to Cheryl, I'm not going to have to go to jail. Isn't that just wonderful? I mean, I'm not even going to have to touch the $50 million that Herbert left us.
Well, that's just peachy.
Yeah, it's great. I mean, the whole family's one. It's wonderful.
Well, and this is first prize.
Well, she's performed a miracle, hasn't she? So we were just celebrating. Would you care to join us for a glass of champagne?
Well, actually, I'd love to. There doesn't seem to be any left.
If Scott and Bobby get here, tell them I had to leave.
Yes, ma'am.